Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about conditional probability. Let's start with something we should already know. So previously on Hegarty Maths we've talked about independent events. Pause the video and double check you can remember what that means. Well, we said that two events A and B, let's say, are independent if the probability of either event occurring is not affected by the other one occurring. Now that was a bit of a mouthful, so let's give an example for that. If A was the event that you flip a coin and it lands on the heads, and B was the event that you roll a dice and it lands on the six, whether A occurs, you get that head, is not dependent at all, or is not affected at all, by whether you get the six on the dice. And similarly, whether you get the six on the dice, the probability of that occurring is not dependent at all about what happens on the flipping of that coin and whether you get heads or not. So those two events, A and B in this case, are what's called independent. The probability of either one occurring is not affected by whether the other occurs or not. Now sometimes though, events can be what we call dependent, or what this video is about, conditional. That's when one of the events happening might affect the other one happening and the probability of it happening. So let me give you an example of something like that. If A was the event that it rains on Saturday and B is the event I go for a walk on the countryside on Saturday, you may think to yourself that, well, the probability of B occurring, the event I go for a walk on a Saturday, it could depend on whether it rains on Saturday. That might affect whether I decide to go for a walk or not. So in that case, it seems that B, that event of me going for a walk, is dependent or conditional on whether it rains or not on Saturday. And the probability of B occurring is affected by whether A occurs. And that's the type of scenario we're dealing with in conditional probability. So let's flesh that out a bit more. We need some notation that we're going to use throughout. So here is notation you need to copy down and learn. The probability, this of A slash B. Now how you say that, you say the probability of A given B, and what it means is it's the probability of A occurring given the fact that B also occurs, or B also has occurred. Going the other way around, probability of B given A, that's how you say that. That means the probability of B occurring given the fact that A also occurs or has occurred. And we're going to use this notation a lot. Now let's link it back to independent events and dependent or conditional events, because this notation comes in really handy. Now with independent events, we know events A and B are independent if the probability of one occurring is not affected by the other. The way you can use the notation to define that, you can say the probability of A happening given B has happened is just the probability of A. A is not affected by B having happened, so the probability of A given B is just the probability of A, as it always was. And similarly, the probability of B happening given A has happened, well, we don't care that A has happened, it's independent, it's just the probability of B. And that's another way of phrasing independence. But on the other hand, dependent events or conditional events, something else is true. Events A and B are dependent or conditional if the probability of either event occurring is affected by the other occurring. So in this scenario, the probability of A happening given B has happened, it's not the probability of A anymore, it's something else that we might have to calculate. But it's certainly, we can't just say it's the probability of A, it has changed. The probability of A happening has now changed given you know B has happened. And similarly, the probability of B given A can't just be the probability of B anymore. It's something else we've got to calculate. So that's a formal way of defining these. So let's go on, and I want to just answer a question we've previously done to show you very clearly independence versus dependent events. So here is something we have already solved before. Pause the video and double check you can solve that. Okay, hopefully you drew yourself the following diagram. Okay, and that would be your probability tree. Now the key idea here was the fact that Paul replaced the marble after the first pick, and what that meant was that the second pick was independent of the first pick. Let me show you what I mean. If he took a blue on the first pick, the probability was 2/7. The probability he takes another blue, given he got a blue on the first pick, is still 2/7, because he put that original marble back in the bag. And you will see 2/7 everywhere where you see the chance to get the probability of a blue. And similarly, the probability of getting a red was 5/7, and it didn't matter whether he got a red in the first pick or not. probability of red throughout the diagram was always 5/7 because he replaced the marbles. Now, I was a bit cheeky when I first presented this to you. I didn't write them like this, okay? I wrote them like this. I just said this was the probability of getting a blue. This was the probability of getting a red. This was the probability of getting a blue. This was the probability of getting a red. And I didn't say given that I've already got a blue or given that I've got a red. The reason is I knew these events were independent because he replaced the marbles. And I knew, for example, the probability of a blue given red was just the probability of blue, as we've just talked about in the case of independent events. But we're now going to deal with cases where they are not necessarily independent. So let's have a look at the next example and see if you can spot the difference. Now, in this case, it seems almost identical scenario. Paul picks a marble out of the bag, notes its colour, but here it says he does not replace it. And that is very, very important. If he does not replace it, well, what you get on the second pick depends on what you did on the first pick, because the number of marbles in the bag have gone down and maybe the number of blues have gone down if you picked a blue. So everything is changed dependent on the first pick. This is what we call a conditional event or a dependent type of scenario. So I've drawn the basic outline for us. Let's try and fill this in and the various probabilities. Let's assume the first pick. As before, the probability that you get a blue is clearly 2 out of 7. That doesn't change. And the probability you get a red, well, that's 5 out of 7. And you'll know, as before and as always, these must always add up to 1. Now, this is where this notation comes in really handy here. Let's assume we go down this here, this route here. Let's assume he picks a blue. So let's take a blue out. Now, the probability he picks another blue, given he already picked a blue. Let's look at the scenario here. There is only one blue now out of a total of 6 possible marbles. The number of blue marbles has gone down, the number of total marbles has gone down. Now, what's the probability he picked a red given he picked a blue on the first one? Well, the number of reds didn't change, so he still has 5 reds out of a total of 6. And again, you'll note these two add up to 1. Now, that's the first potential scenario. Let's assume instead on the first pick he chose a red. Put that blue back and forget that ever happened. Let's consider the other scenario where he actually took a red out. So here, the probability he gets a red given he took a red out on his first pick. Well, the number of reds have gone down by 1 and the number of marbles have gone down by 1, so it's 4/6. What's the probability he gets a blue given he took a red on his first pick? Well, you can see here the blues stayed the same. There's still 2 of them, but the number of marbles has gone down, so it's 2/6, okay? And that is how you fill in the diagram in a case of a dependent or conditional type scenario. Filling in these various probabilities, you just multiply along the branches as we've done before. And that there is our probability tree. Okay, let's get on now and deal with more scenarios like this. Pause the video and have a go at this one. So I'm gonna draw the probability tree out for us in this scenario. So going through this just quickly to explain, the probability on the first pick of a blue is clearly 2 out of 5 and a red is 3 out of 5. That's easy. If you went down this scenario and assume he picked a blue, so you would have taken out one of the blues here, then the probability he gets another blue is now 1 out of 4. You can see the probability he gets a red given he took a blue is now 3 out of 4. But if on the other hand you assume that he went down this scenario here, he took a red on the first pick. So let's assume he took a red, then the probability he gets a red given he took a red is now 2 out of 4, and the probability he gets a blue given he took a red is 2 out of 4. And we multiplied along the probabilities and worked the various ones out. And having drawn the probability tree, we can be asked various questions like this, and we can get all our answers from the tree. What's the probability of 2 reds? Just go back here. 2 reds is this one, 6 over 20, which we can simplify 3/10. Probability of 2 blues, go back here, is 2/20, which again we can simplify as follows. The probability of getting 2 of the same colours, well, it's this one or this one, so we can add those probabilities. 2/20 plus 6/20 is 8/20, which again can be simplified, and you can simplify that to 2/5. The probability of getting two different colors, well, it's this one added to this one. 6/20 add 6/20 is 12/20, which you can simplify again to 3/5. The next one, the probability of exactly one blue, well, exactly one blue is in this case and this case here, which is as we did above, which again must be 3/5. And the probability of at least one blue, well, that is this one added to this one added to this one, which is going to be 14 out of 20, which simplifies to 7/10, and we're done. Okay, last question. Pause the video and have a go at this one. So I'm going to draw the probability tree and work it all out, so just watch me go through. So the probability he chooses two different types of biscuit, well, it's either this scenario or this scenario. If you add them together, you get yourself 60 out of 110, which you can simplify. Dividing top and bottom by 10, you would get yourself 6/11. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.